Well, here's my Spider-Man video. I want to talk about a certain web crawler with red and blue spandex, Spider-Man if you haven't guessed it. So, I could go over some reasons why I'm a pretty big Spider-Man fan. I've read some comics. Spider-Man 2 is one of my favorite video games of all time, and I've seen all the movies, and that's pretty much it. So, why do I feel so strongly about some guy in a red and blue suit? When I was younger, I remember seeing Sam Raimi's Spider-Man with Tobey, Maguire, and I instantly fell in love. I'm not sure how many times I watched it. I guess what I'm trying to say is that this movie has stuck with me for as long as I can remember, and lately, I've been wondering why that is. Why do I keep coming back to Peter Parker in new iterations after so many years and still wanting more? And I've just been wondering, what is it about Spider-Man that I love so much that I've been taking my valuable video game playing time?
No, especially for Halo, like, I haven't really touched anything else but PlayStation.
Do you hear this guy bitching?
Oh, hell no. I'm turning on my mic right now. We doing this. Dog, you know how much of a bitch you sound? You want to tell someone to shut the fuck up? Your goofy ass. Shut the fuck up at the bottom of the fucking leaderboard, bitch.
Yeah,
because he's in our party, bitch. He's my boy. I got you.
Just to make an entire video on the web hub in my spare time with no financial gain. Let's try and figure this out. My name is David, and I'm an aspiring artist. Right now, I just make videos on the side as a hobby, but I've been really into Spider-Man for a while now, and I kind of just want to get some thoughts out of my head, and this is really the only way I know how. With that being said, let's get right into it. I feel these days we've been oversaturated with superhero movies, and it's gotten to the point where, after so many rehashings and reimaginings, I kind of forgot where we started from and why our favorite heroes became so popular in the first place. I thought it'd be a good idea to take a step back and look at the beginning. So, for those of you who don't know, Spider-Man was created by Stan Lee and Steve Ditko. Now, most people know who Stan Lee is, so I'm just gonna go over Steve Ditko's history kind of briefly. I don't want to really get into, like, any of the controversies or anything like that. There's kind of been a debate on who actually created Spider-Man, but the thing that interests me mostly, personally, about Steve Ditko is his approach towards creating comics.
Aristotle said that art is philosophically more important than history. History tells how men did act. Art shows how men could and should act. Art creates a model. An ideal man is a measuring standard. Without a measuring standard, nothing can be identified or judged. A hero measures a man at his best in the worst situations. A hero is a man admired for his qualities or achievements and regarded as an ideal or model. Society has its admirable people, its heroes. They are found in all professions, but hidden by the complexities of society, they are not as clearly defined, not as understood, and not as effective model as a story with two opposing forces of right and wrong in a dramatic presentation, revealing the characters' choices and actions that identify them and lead to a just ending where the hero and the right view of life wins. Early comic book heroes were not about life as it is, but creations of how a man with a clear understanding of right and wrong and more courage chose to act, even if branded an outlaw. He dispensed a better justice than a pervading legal moral one. He was a moral avenger. He was not like everyone else, not the average, the common, or the ordinary man. He was the exceptional one, the uncommon one, the one doing what others were unwilling to do, regardless of the opposition and consequences to himself.
Now, I find this gets at what I'm trying to say here about my reasons for making this video, that heroes are meant to show us what we could be, what we can strive to be. For centuries, humans have been fascinated with stories, people with power, and I think that's still really prevalent today. Spider-Man in particular is a story about a boy that gets bitten by a radioactive spider. So, how can anybody relate to something like that? Well, when you look past all the wall crawling and web slinging, you're left with a 15-year-old kid from Queens who has to get up every morning and make it to school on time. These superhuman abilities, these supervillains, are metaphors for our talents and hardships we face in our everyday life. That's how I put myself into Spider-Man's shoes when he's one swinging through the city. When he puts on his suit and his mask, I see myself like picking up a pencil. And I hope I'm not like sounding crazy to anybody, and I'm hoping like you're starting to get where I'm going with this. When Tobey in Spider-Man 2 put his suit in the trash can and walked away, I felt that I could relate to that. So many times in my life, I just quit drawing because something was going on in my life. I gave up a couple times, and it took me a while to come back, or some aspects about drawing I just truly felt like I could never grasp. Maybe some part of me still feels that way deep down, but the thing is, chances of figuring out those problems drop dramatically when you give and you don't try. Spider-Man gives up many things so he can go out and save people. He makes many sacrifices, and so many times he just goes missing or just doesn't show up at all, and I totally feel that now. Even now, like, some of my friends, we're not able to hang out as often as we used to because we all have responsibilities now, and I think that's something everyone can understand. I think fans of Spider-Man see themselves behind the mask. They see a representation of what is possible for them, and even through all our hardships, Spider-Man shows us that we can deal with loss and not be tainted by it. There's one scene in particular where Peter has given up on being Spider-Man, and he tells a kid that's helping Aunt May, Spider-Man went away because he wanted to try other things. And at this point in the story, to me, Peter is directionless, and for the longest time, that's something I've also struggled with. I didn't want to be identified by one thing, and the world is so huge, how is anyone supposed to figure out what they want to do for the rest of their life when they're that young? And eventually I started to realize the things that are important to me, friends and family, and it's important to figure out what makes you happy and have as much fun as you can doing it. Spider-Man is the most human character there is for me, and a human quality is we make mistakes. We're not perfect. Society just expects us to be. You can almost say Spider-Man is defined by his mistakes, his struggles. He blames himself for his uncle's death, so he does what he can to prevent that from happening again. In that way, he shows us how to deal with grief and loss, shows us we don't have to be weakened by our failures, that we can use them to our advantage. And the people that we have lost don't have to die. They can't, if we keep their ideals alive. In the new Spidey film, Happy says to Peter, "It hurts because they're gone. And then it hurts all over again when you remember what they stood for." Think of Peter Parker talking to Aunt May in the backyard about not getting stuck on the day-to-day grind and to look at the bigger overall picture of things. Like, quitting Spider-Man isn't just going to affect him, it's going to affect the people that look up to him, the people around him.
Wanted to try other things.
He'll be back, right?
I don't know. You'll never guess who he wants to be. Spider-Man.
Why?
Well, he knows a hero when he sees one. Too few characters out there flying around like that, saving old girls like me. And Lord knows, kids like Henry need a hero. Courageous, self-sacrificing people, setting examples for all of us. Everybody loves a hero. People line up for them, cheer them, scream their names, and years later they'll tell how they stood in the rain for hours just to get a glimpse of the one who taught him to hold on a second longer. I believe there's a hero in all of us that keeps us honest, gives us strength, makes us noble, and finally allows us to die with pride, even though sometimes we have to be steady and give up the thing we want the most. Even our dreams. Spider-Man did that for Henry, and he wonders where he's gone. He needs him. Do you think you could lift that desk and put it into the garage for me?
And this is the heart of Spider-Man. I think I also forgot what made him so special to me. Is it so wrong to gain your sense of morals from a comic book character as opposed to any other place? I guess what I'm trying to say is, if I could go back, talk to my younger self, I would just say, it's okay to mess up. It's not okay to give up.
The great strength of Spider-Man as the fact that he's a real person. He's one of us. He's a kid from Brooklyn who doesn't have a lot of money. He's doesn't get the girls. He's got acne. He's fairly average looking kid. He's one of us.
Mysterio is the truth.